Hello everyone, welcome back to part 10.2 of our Endless Runner tutorial series. Today, we're adding a progress bar to the HUD that shows how much time is left for the power-up to deactivate. Before we begin, if you haven't watched part 10.1, please watch it first. The link is in the description. Let's get started. First, in Unreal Engine, open BP underscore runner game mode and create a new variable called magnet timer with the type set to float. Go to BP underscore power up underscore magnet and in the event graph select all the nodes from the delay to destroy actor. Move them down. After the print string node, add a sequence node. Hold Ctrl and change the delay node from then 0 to then 1. Move the print string and sequence nodes away from set is magnet active. Now, as runner game mode, add set magnet timer. Place this node between set magnet active and print string and connect the execution pin. Set the value to the duration of your power-up plus 1 second. For example, in this video, I set the delay to 5 seconds, so I'll set the timer value to 6. If your delay is 10 seconds, set your timer value to 11. Now, let's create a custom for loop function with a delay. Add a for loop node. You don't need to connect it to anything, just double-click on it to open the blueprint library. In the inputs folder or the blueprints folder, right-click in an empty space, go to the blueprints section, and create blueprint macro library. You can name it anything, but I'm naming it for loop delay. Open it and rename the new macro to for loop with delay. In the input section, create 4 inputs, one with the type exec, the second and third with the type integer, and the fourth with the type float. Name the first input execute in lowercase, name the second input first index, name the third input last index, and name the fourth input duration. Create 3 outputs, set the first and third outputs types to exec and the second outputs type to integer. Name the first output loop body, name the second output index, and name the third output completed. Now, select the output node in the graph and move it away. Go to the magnet blueprint and double-click on the for loop node to open standard macros. Copy everything except the inputs and outputs nodes and paste it into for loop with delay. Connect the input execution pin to the assigned node. Connect the first index to the value pin of the assigned node. Connect the last index to the second pin of the less than or equal to node. Connect the false pin of the branch node to the completed pin of that output node, and connect the then 0 pin of the sequence to the loop body. Connect the index pin to the local integer node. From then 1, add a delay node and connect the duration value pin to the duration pin of the input node. Save it. In the magnet blueprint event graph, from then 0, add for loop with delay. Set the duration value to 1 and the last index value to the value of the magnet timer variable we set earlier. Add Get Magnet Timer as runner game mode and move it towards for loop with delay. From Get Magnet Timer, add Decrement Float and connect the execution pins. Then, from the return value of the Decrement Float node, add a Max Float node. After that, add Set Magnet Timer as runner game mode and connect the execution pin to the Decrement Float node. And connect the return value of the Max Float to the Magnet Timer pin of the Set Magnet Timer node. Add a Print String node and connect the return value of the Set Magnet Timer to the string pin of the Print String node. Compile and save. Go to the level and press play. You'll see that the timer is working correctly. Now, let's add the progress bar. Open Gameplay underscore UI. In the palette tab, add a progress bar. Set the anchor to bottom left and adjust the position. In the Details tab, set the size X between 350 to 450 and the size Y to 25 or 30. You can also change the color of the progress bar in the Appearance section in the Details tab and increase the percent in the Progress section to see how it will look. Now, let's create a binding. Select the drop-down beside the percent and click Create New Binding. Change the name of the binding to Get underscore Magnet underscore percent. Select the return node, move it away, and add Get Game Mode from it. Cast to Runner Game Mode. Add Get Magnet Timer as Runner Game Mode. Add a divide node and set the value to -1 times your magnet timer value. In the magnet blueprint, you set the magnet timer value to 6, so set the divide by value to 5. Connect the divide node's return value to the return value of the return node. Connect the execution pins, then compile. In the level, press play. After collecting the magnet, the progress bar works. However, it gets stuck at the last value. To fix this, go to the magnet blueprint and increase the value of the delay that deactivates the magnet by 0.2. After doing this, play again, and you'll see that it works correctly. But we don't want the progress bar to appear on the screen all the time. To fix this, go to Gameplay underscore UI and in the Event Graph, add an Event Tick node. After that, add Get Owning Player Pawn, then cast to Runner Character as Runner Character. Add Get His Magnet Active from it, and then add a branch. From the Variables tab, drag and drop the progress bar. Add a Set Visibility node, there are two nodes with the same name, either will work, and connect it to the true pin of the branch node. Make sure the Set Visibility node's value is set to visible. Duplicate the node, connect it to the false pin, and change its visibility to hidden. Connect the progress bar pin to the target. Compile and save. Go to the level and press play. you'll notice that everything works perfectly. And that's it for today's video. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you encounter any errors or need assistance, feel free to contact me via email or Discord. You can find the details in the description. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.